If you want to light up your model railroad and want to see how to get this breadboard assembled so you could do it easily, you're going to want to watch this video right now. I'm Tom Govichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And we're going to take this breadboard that I showed you the other day. I'm going to disassemble everything on here and rearrange it and show you how to do it. I figured out a different way of doing it. When you're doing a breadboard, you're putting the components on there just to test it out and to see how it would work and experiment with it. But since I have the design of it correct, I figured out a way to rearrange it on there a little bit better. So we have the LED on one side of the breadboard and everything else on the other side of the breadboard. And I also made one for the mini breadboard that doesn't have a power bus along the side on each side of them. So I put a little connector on there. Transferring this to a circuit board is a next step after I show you how to put it on these little breadboards here. Now that'll be another video after this showing you how to put it on a circuit board. Something similar to this, where you have to put jumpers on the back of it. This has holes similar to what's on the breadboard. Now you can buy circuit boards in different sizes. I bought a pack of circuit boards that have, I think, 1, 2, 3, 5 assorted sizes. You can also get circuit boards that have the traces that are similar to the bands that are on the breadboard. Now on the breadboard, you have the power buses on either end. You can see how the power bus works. And then the working area. Everything is common in that direction right there. Here's the schematic diagram of what we're working with. I'm going to show this battery here as our power source with the plus and the minus right here. Now we have the first resistor here, R1, which is the 680 ohm resistor. This one right here is the 150k ohm resistor. And this is the trim pot. This is our variable resistor. This is our Q1, it's a SS8050. And this is our LED. We could use any LED we want right there. Now we'll go over to what it looks like on the breadboard. And we'll see the same thing over here. This is R1, which is the 680 ohm resistor. This is the R2, which is the 150k ohm resistor. And you'll see that they are both connected to the positive terminal there. Okay, now this 680, as you can see, goes all the way up to the anode of the LED, which is right here. Okay, this resistor right here, 150 k-ohm, goes on to one leg of the potentiometer right here. Right there. The center post of this one goes up to the transistor, the base of the transistor, which is right here. The other leg of the trim pot goes down to your negative, and it also goes to the emitter of your transistor. Now on the actual breadboard that I'm working on, I moved it down to these terminals right here. I'm just showing it right here because it's a little bit clearer like this. But I put these two leads, the base and the emitter, right here and here, and I put the collector in this one. I just bent it up to fit over on this one right here. But it's the same thing as coming down like this. Okay, and then moving this up to there. But anyway, that's what that is right there. That's the emitter, which comes onto the other side of the variable resistor and goes to your negative terminal on your power source. And then the other side of the transistor, which is right here, goes up to the cathode of your LED right there. So that's the entire wiring diagram in there. You have two fixed resistors, a variable resistor, a transistor, and an LED. And that's what it looks like here. I'm just showing you one instance of it, but when we do it, we'll put a couple of them on here. And the video after this one, we're going to show you how to put all of this on your PC board. We're going to start off on this breadboard on this side. We're going to do a couple of them. And the first thing we're going to use on here is the 680 ohm resistor. And how we're going to do this is we're going to connect it to the positive rail. And let me turn this around this way so it'll make it a little bit easier. And we'll just take it for the positive rail and then come up here like that. And then we'll take the 150K. Now we're not going to trim a lot off of here. And we'll stick it in the next slot down on both the positive and the working part of it. Now we're going to put a jumper in here. And this jumper is going to go on the opposite leg of the potentiometer, but it's going to go from the negative terminal. So we're going to put it like right here. Okay, so now we got that. You can see our potentiometer here, and they have some slots in there to set it, and it'll set it back just in case you have some wires in there. And the way we're going to put it in there is like this. We're going to put it up as close as we can to the front. Maybe that's a little bit too close. We'll try this one right here. Okay, right there, and that gives us enough in the back for our transistor. We're going to do on this one here, we're going to bridge the gap in there and move it over some. But before I do that, let me put this other jumper in here. I'll put this one right here, and we'll put that jumper right there. Okay, and that'll connect this resistor all the way up and put it on this side. All right, now with this transistor right here, like I showed you in the diagram before, we have the emitter on the side where the side of the potentiometer that goes to the negative. This is the base, and then this is the collector. So we're just going to put it over here. We're going to try to bridge this over, and I might have to get this a little bit further out. And so, as you can see right here, and let me use my X-Acto, this is the emitter in this pin right here. On the base of this one is the base of the transistor, and the collector is on this side over here. Now we're going to put our LED. We're going to take our long one and put it where the jumper is, and we'll just stick it right up here. I'm going to stick the power supply on here. There we go. Yeah, on these longer ones, there's no connection between this side and this side here. So you can see that one works. And let me get my screwdriver. These always have slots in them. And if I would have cut these resistors down, they would have been down lower. But just for the sake of doing this, we'll show you how that increases. So we're testing it out right away. Okay, so we'll take the power off of it. That's our first one. Now we'll go over to the next one. And we'll do the same thing. We'll go from here to right there. There we go. Got it in there. Get my other resistor. Put that in the next one. Let me get my needle nose. And I'll just shove that in there with that. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we got those two resistors. We'll skip one and put in a jumper. And put it on the negative. Let's turn this in just a little bit. Get this a little bit. There we go. And get there we go. Okay, we'll take this potentiometer and put it right here. And I think what we're going to do here, we're going to put a couple of, okay, we'll take, let's see if I can find, if I got the right length jumpers here. Let me put another white one over here for the one end of our LED. Just bend that down a little bit more. I'm going to speed this up a little bit while I put the transistor in there. And what I'm going to do is place the transistor like I showed in the diagram across from the center gap. So just to show you that it works just like I had it in the diagram. On here, the emitter is on the left, the base is in the center, and the collector is on the right, and we'll put the LED in there so we could apply power and watch this thing light up again. Now we'll apply the power and adjust it so we could see the difference in the brightness of the two LEDs. And there we go, the brightness and the dim on both of them. Okay, there it is, all the way up to the brightness on there. Let me turn the lights out here. I'll show it that way, and then we'll bring it down. Let me put it to about right there, so you can see them. So even at not quite halfway, they're still pretty bright. And we spent so much time on this one here that I'm not going to have enough time. I mean, we're already at about 16 minutes, going on 16 minutes. And this one here, I'm going to do on the next one, show you how to do this. I'm going to do the same thing. show you the diagram. Well, the diagram is going to be the same, but I'm going to show you how to put it on the mini breadboard, and then after that we're going to put it on the PC board, like one of these right here. We might do this one here, or we might do one. I think we'll do this one right here. We'll see. On this breadboard here, you could run as many as 10 circuits on here as far as this one goes, like here. I only did the two. We ran out of time with these two. On the next video, I'm going to show you how to do this, and I may show you how these transistors work to increase the brightness on here while we operate the potentiometers on there. So take a look for that coming up in the future episodes, and we'll see ya.